am now going to give you all a scenario where while loops are seemingly important. Assume I'm a doctor. I have my own clinic. I must treat my patients. And assume I'm a popular doctor. There are a lot of patients. And what I do is I give them a token number. My receptionist gives them with token numbers. I start with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and I go on like this. And I treat my patients one after the other. How can I write a program for this? I will now write a program for this and put a monitor outside my clinic door, which is in the reception area, where people can see which token number is being called for right now, and that concerned person can come inside. Let us see how we can achieve this using a while loop. Okay, now look at this. I will first write the code and then let us understand what this code does. While c is equal to 1, print token number n, may please come in. Okay, perfect. What will this n be? It should be a number starting from 1, and then it should become 2, it should become 3, and so on. So it should first be assigned 1. Okay, what is c? I'll tell you in a minute. Let me assign c to be 1. So now what I will do is I'll simply say input c equals input continue ? 0/1. What do I mean by this? See, you know what happens here? C is a number basically. Okay, so I'll say int c. Okay, c is a number. When c is 0, it will come here and it will see while c equals 1. When c is 0, c is not equal to 1. So it will not pass this loop. It will not come down. It will not execute this. But when c is 1, it will execute this. Now, you have practiced this enough right now, given that I asked you to practice it. You know what while loop is. While loop simply keeps executing whatever is below. While loop keeps executing this until this becomes false. I repeat. When the condition given here is true, where whatever is inside this bracket after a while, when the condition is true, it will keep executing this. It will keep executing until this becomes false. But the moment this becomes false, it will come out of it. Okay, it's like a bomb detonator, right? So it will keep executing this until this goes false. Once it goes false, boom, it comes out. Okay, let me type here, print, thank you. This is the end of our day, rather today. Okay, before anything, I will say print, hello everyone, we are starting. Now let's see what happens to this. As I execute this, the first line will get executed. Okay, hello everyone we are starting. N becomes 1, c becomes 1, while c is 1, absolutely c is indeed 1. So you come inside, print token number n, may please come in, token number 1 may please come in, continue 0 or 1. If you say 1 here, c will be taken as 1, but then you see the input always gives c as a string. You see, we have discussed this many times, right? So I make it a number, okay? For some time, you please ignore this command. You just, by ignore, I mean, just write it. know that you have to write it. With time you will understand what that is, right? The one big mistake that people do, especially teachers, is teach everything about programming in one shot. It doesn't work. You have to have this knack to ignore a few details and grasp only the most important things. With time, these details will become easy on your minds, provided you keep looking at it again and again, right? So don't worry much about this. We'll revisit this sometime later, okay? Actually, we have discussed this already, but don't worry much about it. It is to convert the entity C onto an integer. Okay, fine. So now I come here and I again go here and then C continues. Okay, continue one, enter. Uh-oh, it is saying token number one may please come in. This should not be the case. It should say token number two may please come in. Correct? So what should I do? I should ensure that I increment C by 1, okay? I must increment N by 1. Why? So that next time when it comes, it says token number 2 may please come in. So let me come here, exit this by pressing 0. See, it exits. In a moment, it will be clear to you. Let me again execute this. Print hello, we are starting. Hello everyone, we are starting. Token number 1 may please come in. Continue 0 or 1. This is for me. Okay. If I say 1, by 1 I mean, see, the 1 here is token number 1. The 1 here is a command to my program to continue or not. Okay. When I say 1, it says token number 2 may please come in. So what I'll do as a doctor, I'll treat my patient. Once the patient is done, he walks out. For the next patient, I will say, I'll enter 1 here, enter. Token number 3 may please come in. My next patient comes. I treat this little kid and then I say bye to the kid and the kid goes out. And then I again press 1 as a doctor. It says token number 4 may please come in. The next person comes in. I treat that patient and then I keep doing this. So I'm a very hardworking medical practitioner. So I treat some 20 patients or even more. I go on, you see, and finally I arrive at, let's say, 36 patients and everybody is done. What do I do now? Continue 0 or 1, right? It says continue 0 or 1. I say I am done. Let me press 0, enter. It comes out. Thank you, this is the end of our day. Why does it say that? Because when you press 0, C becomes equal to this, right? And C becomes equal to 0, and when C is not 1, if it's only 1, it enters. When it is not 1, it will come out. Once it comes out, it will say thank you, this is the end of our day. And that's what happened here. As and always, I repeat, and I'll repeat this many times and over, the key idea about learning a programming language. When it comes to learning a programming language, the key idea is repeatedly do the same program a few times. Delete this program and redo it. Again delete it, again redo it. Keep doing this until you're very familiar with what is happening where. And then take up more challenging exercises on the same topic and then write your code. And there you are, you would become an expert in no time, right? Take this tip very seriously. Now close this screen and you try writing this program all by yourself. How would you make this counter increment and then stop when you ask it to stop by pressing 0? Okay, perfect. See you all.